Welcome back, everybody. It's time for our morning talker. David Letterman signed off last night for the last time. He is stepping down from The Late Show. Letterman said goodbye after 33 years and 6,028 broadcasts of his late night show. And as you can see, he was ushered out by four U.S. presidents. Then 10 stars from Steve Martin to Tina Fey delivered the final top 10 list of things I've always wanted to say to Dave. We bring in our friends over at Fun 107, Michael Rock and Lauren, to chat about this. Hi, guys.
Hi, good morning.
Good morning.
It's the end of an era.
It is. You know, I was thinking about this last night when I was watching the show. I don't remember. I mean, I do remember when Johnny retired, it was a big deal. Mm-hmm. But when Lena retired, he didn't get this much fanfare, did he?
Well, he
yeah,
did,
I don't
but
think
then
so.
He came back.
Retired three times.
Right. Remember, he was leaving to go do that other
twice,
show.
I guess that's...
Well, yeah, that changes things.
It wasn't a complete retirement. Yeah. Gone.
Yeah.
So I like what they did. I haven't seen the whole thing yet, but the clips that I've seen so far, they went all out. It's always nice to see everybody coming back and joking with him. At 33 years, that's a long time.
Yeah. That is a long time.
6,000.
Yeah, something like
he's
that.
He's getting close 6, to Regis.
6,028 shows. Michael, I'm impressed that you were awake watching.
I know.
Well, I take our show very seriously, Doreen. I want to make sure we're prepared for the morning show.
I know, it is tricky when you know you're going to need to talk about something that's on late at night.
Right.
But it's funny because, you know, we were saying that we all wake up so early, so it's been a long time since any of us were able to watch any late night show. But it, just knowing that it's there, you know, and now it's not, and it's just it's kind weird. Of a thing, you know. It's like anytime a favorite show ends.
I think the other part of that is that Letterman knew that he could not keep up with Fallon and Kimmel with people. People don't even really watch the show anymore. Like nobody stays up till 11:35 to actually watch it on television. You watch it on the internet. And
yeah, later.
Letterman knew, I just can't do that.
Yeah.
That's what he told. Yeah. He did tell that to Rolling Stones in a piece they did on him.
Yeah.
That those viral videos are really what did him in.
Yeah, I mean, Jimmy Kimmel's always good. And Jimmy ran a rerun last night, actually, we should mention. So that
right.
People
very
could
cool.
That was really nice.
Yeah.
Yeah. Really nice.
All right, Mike really wanted to talk about
all right,
this one.
Apparently this is something that actually happens a lot. I didn't realize this. But a Texas woman, I thought this was funny, she won't be straight on the toilet bowl. She made a wedding dress out of toilet paper. You know that song? Okay. It's part of a competition, the woman using the TP, tape, and glue. She even boiled some of it to kind of make it easier to work with. The former Marine, now stay-at-home mom, is hoping to win the $10,000 prize that comes with this competition.
And Lauren, you weren't married that long ago. Did you have that game at your shower? When the wedding dress.
Have you heard played games, though? But not that one.
Yeah.
We've both heard of it
before.
Where you have to, you go to a shower and there's multiple rolls of toilet paper and it ends up looking like a mummy, is what we were saying earlier.
I've honestly never heard of this game before.
Really?
No? This is new to me.
Yes, I remember walking into one of my friend's showers with a big BJ size thing of toilet paper. Necessary element for
it sounded,
a shower.
We were just talking on the radio.
Exactly. So I mean, that one looks much nicer.
We were just talking on the radio about what Lady Gaga's going to wear for her wedding dress. This could be a candidate.
Could be. You never know with Lady Gaga.
Right? Very, very true.
Hopefully she doesn't get it stuck on her shoe.
You've been waiting all morning for that.
Waiting.
And on that note, everybody, we'll see you guys next week. Have a great holiday weekend.
You too.
Thanks.
Right.